My name is Lucille Gaucher. I'm Product and Application Specialist for CHOPIN Technology. Today, we will be going over the Mixolab, a device for measuring the rheological characteristic of a dough during mixing. The Mixolab 2 comes with one mixer bowl. Here is clean and already in place. One filling hopper, one cleaning brush, and one mini PC, a central unit dedicated to run the Mixolab. Before powering up the device, we have to check if the water tank is empty and fill it with distilled water if necessary. Now we will turn on the cooling system and turn the Mixolab on. For the Mixolab, the power button is located on the rear of the device next to the power cable. And LED located on the front will flash red, orange, green during the initialization phase. It is going to last 1 or 2 minutes. Finally, we will turn on the mini PC and the Mixolab will be ready to run. Before starting a test, ensure that the nozzle is positioned on the tank. In order to run a test, you need first to configure the test within the software. Click on Test, then Prepare a Mixolab test. You are going to select a protocol. For this video, we will take the example of the standard CHOPIN Plus protocol. You will also need to enter the desired hydration. We recommend to use 55% for white flour and 60% for whole grain flour. You will then enter the hydration base, always 14% for standard CHOPIN Plus protocol, and the water content of the sample that has been measured beforehand. Once all the information is put in, the software will automatically calculate the flour weight to be prepared. You are going to weigh out the quantity of flour indicated by the software to an accuracy of plus and minus 0.1 gram and leave it close to the Mixolab. At this point, all you need is to click on the start icon on the software to launch the test. The LED will turn orange, which means that the test is underway and Blaze will start to run. When a message asking the user to add flour appears, you are going to place the hopper on the top of the mixing bowl and gradually add the flour to the hopper. After 30 seconds, another message will appear asking the user to place the nozzle onto the mixing bowl. You are going to wipe the nozzle, clean it, and then place it into the nozzle holder. When all the parameters have reached their reference values, the measurements will start automatically. After 45 minutes, in the case of the standard CHOPIN Plus protocol, the test will stop automatically and the test results are displayed. After your test has stopped and the mixing bowl has cooled down, the LED will turn green. At this point, you will clean the nozzle and put it back on the water tank. You will open the lid, unlock the bowl using the locking handle and pull out the mixing bowl. You are going to unscrew the positioning screw from the mixing bowl, the front cover, the two mixing arms, the back cover, and immerse all parts into water and clean them carefully. Once all is clean and dried, you are going to reassemble all the parts. Finally, you will put it back at its position and you will lock it, moving the locking handle to the left. The device is ready for running another test. If all tests are completed, you can close the software and switch off the Mixolab. I hope this presentation was useful. For more information about our product, please visit us at www.capiamanalytics.com. Thank you!